What's going on, everybody? Dotodoya here with another discussion video for Dragon Ball FighterZ, and this time I wanted to discuss the lack of a combo breaker feature in the game. I felt the need to do this video after seeing two comments on my recent video, so big shoutouts to YouTube users MJ Dark and Cashy316. Before I go any further with this video, I should explain what a combo breaker is for those of you that don't know. I consider a combo breaker mechanic to be any mechanic that allows you to escape from an otherwise inescapable combo. And combo breakers can be implemented a lot of different ways in different games. For example, Killer Instinct handles it differently than Mortal Kombat, and you know, all sorts of other examples. How these combo breaker mechanics are implemented can often have huge effects on the way the games are played at both high levels and casual levels alike. For example, Guilty Gear makes it so you can only use a combo breaker around once per round, whereas in Killer Instinct it's kind of a core component of the game. One very common way to implement these combo breaker mechanics, if the developers choose to do so, is to make them cost meter. Obviously, this adds an element of risk and reward to it. You might not want to spend that meter when you could use it in your own combo to kill, but you might also really need to just live so you can have your second chance at winning the game. And this all brings us back to Dragon Ball FighterZ, which doesn't have a real combo breaker mechanic. Sparking Blast can definitely serve as a get off of me kind of tool for wake up, but it's not going to get you out of an active combo. So really, this is the point of the video, which is to start a discussion on whether or not you believe that Dragon Ball FighterZ could use a combo breaker mechanic or not. Obviously, it's a very subjective topic, so I would love to hear your thoughts on it. To get my opinion on combo breaking in Dragon Ball FighterZ, let's go back to Cashy's comment. First, he brings up the limited defense options in the game, and I actually agree with him here. The three defensive options we have in this game are blocking, reflecting, and guard cancel. With three options, defense really doesn't have too much to wrap your head around. If you're utilizing all three of these and making sure to tech throws, then you should be on a pretty good path. But in my opinion, this isn't necessarily a bad thing. I feel like these defensive options are more than interesting enough to keep the experience fun and interesting when you are playing defense against an opponent. But if you do believe that there isn't enough defensive options in the game, then a combo breaker mechanic could be an option. But I think there are certain things you should keep in mind when deciding whether or not you think it would be better for Dragon Ball FighterZ to add a combo breaker mechanic. The first thing to keep in mind would be how many touches it takes to kill a character. In my opinion, at the top level, really good players with optimized combos will be able to kill your character in 2 hits. Hits, of course, meaning different combo starters. And then you have to keep in mind that you have 3 characters on your team at all times. This means that in order to win a game, your opponent has to open you up 6 times, essentially. And this isn't even accounting for managing your blue health correctly. If you're able to switch out your characters when they have a good amount of blue health, you could be extending the game to 7 or 8 hits. Adding a combo breaker mechanic to this would increase the number of times you would have to open up your opponent to get a win. And again, that could be a positive or a negative for you, depending on where you fall in this discussion. Keep in mind that this would extend the amount of time that matches go on for. And again, that could be either a positive or a negative, depending on what you think of the length of matches in Dragon Ball FighterZ. Personally, I feel the game hits a really nice sweet spot right about now, with some matches that are really intense taking a good amount of time, and stomps getting over with relatively quickly. The next thing you would have to consider is how the combo breaker mechanic would be added. Would you prefer it to cost a certain amount of meter, or would you just enjoy the mechanic being a once per game type of deal? Personally, if they were to add a combo breaker mechanic, I would rather they go with just once per game, because you can build meter extremely fast in this game. You get a lot of it just from moving towards your opponent. And because of that, they would have to make the meter cost high as to not make it ridiculously boring on offense, because every combo you would start would just be broken instantly. And then as a byproduct of that, more people would want to save their meter, resulting in flashy, cool combos happening less often, and overall bringing down the overall flow of the game. And that's about all my thoughts on the limited defensive options in the game, as well as adding in a combo breaker mechanic. To summarize my thoughts here at the end, I would say that while limited, the defensive options already in this game provide more than enough options for you to engage on defense. And a combo breaker mechanic would probably be a little overkill. And even if it was implemented really well, I think it would slow down the pace of a game a little too much for my liking. But again, this is super subjective, and I would love to hear your thoughts on this down in the comments below. And while you're down there, if you like this video and channel, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe. I'm Dotodoya, and I'll see you in the next video.